Well, I don't know how well my little dash cam there is going to work, but I got home and I got about 10 minutes of sunlight left, so I threw all the little planes I've been trying to fly in the back of the old van here, and I'm going to head down to the pond, try to get a little fly in it. It's the first, like, really calm evening I've had in quite a while. See, here we have about that much daylight left. Since I haven't flown the Timber in quite a while, and I did get the Beaver up and going the other day, I might fly it first. Get it kind of dialed in. I haven't actually played with the settings on it in a long time because it's usually my go-to just grab and fly plane. Actually, I'm going to throw these bad boys on since I got to walk on the pond with my cowboy boots. And if you don't know what these are, your life is too easy. Come up north for a while. Enjoy the winter with us. Careful. If I got any extra daylight, I might fly my little micro DH-88 that I built. Perfect. A little skiff of snow on the ice to soften the impact. Ice is a little unforgiving. I kind of prefer tall grass to mask my poor landing zone, but the cool thing with these little micros is I have in one shirt pocket all the batteries I need for an evening of flying here. So hold on to those, will you, Beaver? What are we going to use here? I've flown this thing with the 450s a few times, but I'm going to start them off with the little 280s that they kind of came with. Turn my transmitter on here. You hear the ice doing the old crack, crack, crack under me? Unnerving sound if you're not used to it. Timber. You gotta cheat it as far forward as I can on my little balsa mount that I have in there. But that balsa mount's actually so I can fit those bigger batteries further back and closer to the center of gravity. So it makes using the little batteries actually harder. And then, of course, my nose and my hatch, none of that really lines up like it should anymore, so the magnets barely hold it on. I usually have a rubber band on there, but I lost it, so we'll just go like that. There she is. If I can remember what I had all the switches set up for, I think that's safe mode. It's obviously my flaps. Quick check of everything. Motor arm. Oh, that's that fluffy little snow. It's sticky. Hard for the little floats to get through it. Kind of got to power up. Pretty hard to beat the Timber. It's got a lot of really cool features on it. Lights, which I probably should have flown the Beaver first since I won't have lights on it. I've flown this thing well into dusk numerous times. The main things you notice is the Timber is way lighter and it's got about 2 inches more wing and a little bit of dihedral. So when I come in, and I turn a little flap on, this thing will slow right down. Of course, it comes with safe mode, which is great for beginners. The FT Beaver only has whatever receiver you've decided to put in it, so. Alright, I know the Beaver's going to take a little longer to take off. I better get it in the air before it's too dark. So I'm going to move the old camera out over yonder. Alright. How's that for stall? Okay, I think I'm going to start off with the 400. just to keep it light, a little more comparable to what the timber does. Better switch planes here. Okay. Now, last flight I actually got my balance lead wedged in behind one of my servos and took kind of a digger and actually mussed up my floats a little bit and knocked the screw hole loose on my wing, so that's definitely something that can happen, but it was a hell of a crash and the plane held up really well, so I am pretty pleased at the durability of this versus the timber. And you can see I've got an AS3X receiver in this one too. Turn it back in manual mode for takeoff here. Takeoff flaps. See if I can get out over my camera. Woo! I don't think that battery's fully charged. That wasn't a very pretty takeoff. I'm full throttle. That might have been the wrong battery. No need flaps. Yeah, we'll bring her back in after a circle here. Turn on AS3X. You see how much it smooths out. Makes a big difference on these little planes. You definitely notice this isn't as powerful feeling. The timber's got such a light wing loading and low overall weight in general that it feels quite a bit more spunky than this plane does, but this one sure flies nice. Kind of coming right over my camera. Yeah, I feel really underpowered with that battery. That battery might be an old cruddy one. Let's switch out real quick. Let's throw a 750. And honestly, one of the things I do like about this plane, even though you're a heavier overall plane, you'll punch through the wind a little bit better and it flies a little more scale. You'll have a little bit more weight going through your maneuvers, especially you'll notice it on landing where the drop the flaps on the old Beaver or on the timber, and she'll, oh, of course I didn't have that even recording. Yeah, if you drop the flaps on the timber, she'll slow down in a matter of feet. But this one, you kind of got to bleed the speed off because you got a little bit more weight. There we go. See if that helps the situation at all. I don't know if I've actually tried one of those 400 yet. Maybe that was a different battery. All right. Oh, that feels way better. Oh yeah, much better. She seems to like the weight a little too. You can see she flies quite a bit faster. Oh, my battery died on my other camera. That's why it keeps turning off. I'm gonna do a couple just touch and goes with it here. I guess since I don't have a camera, it doesn't really matter where I land, so. I'm gonna come over here, get some fresh snow, just show you what the landing looks like, one plane versus the other. Especially with this bigger battery in it, you'll kind of get a sense of the weight. Yeah, without lights, it gets really hard to see a blue plane in the white and blue sky. See that? Woo! Kick the flaps on, and other than a little pitch up on the elevator, because they don't have elevator dialed in, really. You'll notice. I'll see how slow I can get it going this time. I'll see if I can really slow it down. There, you see, you got to really bleed the speed off, get your flaps on kind of early, and you can see the distance it takes to get her shut down. Let's see if I can take that nick out of the propeller. That's from my my oopsie here. Do another one of those. We'll just do the whole circle with light flaps on. Come in, landing flaps about right here. Just like so. All right, let's put the Beaver back up. This thing's getting pretty hard to see. Okay, I'm gonna put in a little heavier battery just so you get an idea. Even the playing fields, I put the heavy battery in the Beaver, so we'll go ahead and put the heavy battery in the Timber as well. You see, I have to set that one pretty far back to get a 450 in there, but I really like the way it flies with a little bit of extra weight, so I've actually probably flown more with that battery, especially on the floats. They're a little more solid than the little wire wheeled landing gear. Okay. All right, we'll do a punch out and take off with quarter flaps like we were doing with the Beaver. Oh, we're gonna have to get off of the frozen spot where we stopped. Okay. Yeah, the lights make a difference. I'm gonna have to put lights on the Beaver. Yeah, full throttle with the Timber here is about what the Beaver flies at normally, so let's do a pass. Okay. I'll go over here where we got these fresh tracks and we'll compare the Beaver and the Timber's landing. We'll start with the flaps on from way over there so you can see just how slow she'll come in. That's what the extra weight will do for you. Now, of course, on this funny little frosty, fluffy snow, these chowdered up floats are actually gonna have an effect on how I can get off, because you can see how sticky it was just trying to take off where the Beaver kind of cut through it and took off. So let's do that again. Oh, sticky snow, there you go. This thing will jump in the air in about 2 feet with the wheels on it, or if it's on good snow. So let's see if we can beat that. I'll bring her in and set her right on it if I can. Nope, overshot. About the same distance with a bounce. I'm not gonna make it take off in that crap again. Let's do this. All right. I can do a better point landing than that. We'll have to try that again. Hey, that's a little better. About 2 foot. I don't know if I'm brave enough to fly the little black magic tonight. Black plane in the dark seems even harder. I don't know if the Beaver has quite the climb out that the Timber does. That's another weight thing. And I've got a 450 in this, so. Oh, there's a little breeze coming now. I can feel it. Watch what it'll do in a breeze. Just stand there. Almost an imperceptible breeze. And that's how much you can slow this thing down to. get above that little hill where the breeze is rolling over instead of below it. There. 2 inches with the help of a tiny, tiny little breeze. Best landing of the, or best, shortest landing anyway. I don't know about the best. Of course, you gotta charge the battery, you gotta finish it off. Well, really hard to pick a favorite of the two. I really like them both. I think I'd take the Beaver out in a bit more wind. It's a little heavier, got a little more speed to it. The mass kind of helps. This definitely has it trumped in the stole category. It can hop off the ground in a couple of feet and land pretty much on a dime. Quite a bit slower, but you know, you saw there just a second ago, the tiniest little breeze. Even just sit, watch them sitting here, you can see how much lighter it is. That also makes it a fair bit less durable. It's taken some pretty good diggers. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but one of the first times I flew it, I cartwheeled it and I split the fuselage in a bunch of places and had to glue the whole wing back on, and this whole part of the fuselage on both sides just shredded it. Thought it was done for, but once I got it in and got it glued up, it's flown quite a bit since then. But you can see how well, you know, I've flown a lot and abused it, and it's been hammered in and beat up and chowdered, and it's still flying. So it's not like it's, not like it's, you know, unnecessarily fragile for as impressive as it is in the lightweight stall thing. I mean, if you had a big enough building, it would easily fly indoors, and you're not going to get that thing indoors unless you're a pretty good hand, even with flaps. So I guess they each have their place. Kind of glad to have both of them, but two of my favorite little go-to planes.